Hey, what's up YouTube? Today I'm going to be doing a review on my SIGSAR P226 airsoft gun. This is what the gun looks like. Let me start off by saying that this gun is all plastic. There's a lot of rattling. It's very lifelike though. It has a weight of the real gun, and like I said, everything on this gun is plastic except inside of it itself. I don't know what you would call that exactly. I tried to take apart this gun, and these screws are plastic. They will not come off. These screws right here are plastic. So you know, no bother. Don't try taking it off. Orange tip does not come off. I was gonna paint the gun black, but I'm thinking about taking it back to Walmart, because that's where I got it from. I got it with an extra, or I got it with a M4. M4 is broken. I would do a review of that too. So I only got two pistol reviews. Alright, let me, magazine comes out. Magazine holds, I want to say, I think it's 15 rounds. It's not a U mag, so it doesn't go up and it curves around. There's a little silver weight in there to give it a little bit more realistic weight. It's got a pretty good feel to it. It comes apart. There's this little knob on the side right there, that big black dot. You just take that and you push that through. And if you notice, this part right here will actually, or that little, this piece right here will pop out. And then you just, bam, pop that out. Make sure that your gun isn't cocked though, because if it is, it will not let you take it out. And then it's easy. Just slide it forward. You hear a little click. And then just lift out. And then you could take apart your gun like that, you know, clearing the jams. In order to clear a jam, you just pull this little plastic piece right here back, and then it'll just spin back on its own. And then to put it back together, you just slide it back on. You gotta kind of pull it back a little bit, because then the two circles, I don't know if you can see that very well, but see, the two circles aren't really lined up, and then you got to pull it back a little bit in order to get that pin back through. Then you just push it back through, and you're ready to go. Safety is on the side. It is a right-handed gun. It's not universal. It's a right-handed gun. Up is off safe, and down is on safe. You can't pull the trigger. And now I have it off of safety. This gun stays back in the slide position, but it's kind of tough to get it to stay there sometimes. Magazine comes out. In order to get it back to cocked, you just pull it back a little bit, and then just let it go. It'll go forward. Honestly, something that I think is the coolest part about this gun here is the hammer. The hammer on the back right here actually works. You pull that back, the hammer right here, pull that back, and then pull the trigger, let it go forward, pull back, trigger, go forward, go forward. I have the gun disassembled right now. Sometimes if I get bored, I like to time myself, see how fast I can get it done. And that's basically it. That's the SIGSAR P226. My next gun is the Taurus P, or the Taurus PT247. It's a CO2. There's not really much to go over about this gun. You can't cock it back. And it's, you know, you can rapid fire it. You take this, you see that, you gotta take a Allen wrench, or I can't remember what they're called, and you twist that off, and the CO2 will come out. And the CO2, you can actually see it, it's right there, it's Crosswind. Use the Crosswind brand, don't use any other brand, unless it's recommended by the gun maker. I always use Crosswind, because I think Crosswind is really reliable. Let's see, the grip on this is really good, nice, really nice rubber grip, and it has little grooves going on right there, so you can hold your finger like that. The trigger's metal, and the magazine is, I don't know if that's metal or not. If it's not metal, it's very, very strong plastic. I've dropped this gun a couple times and it's still perfect condition, except I need to get a new magazine for it, because what happened is that one day I was trying to take it apart, and I took the CO2 out, except I turned it the wrong way. I turned it right, and I heard a big pop, and I'm like, oh shit, I turned it the wrong way. So I take that out, and a little piece of like a little sharp piece in the part that the CO2 goes into right here, right down there, it goes right through the CO2. That broke off. Yeah, so I'm gonna need a new magazine. There's a cool trick to this gun that uses. It's not like the regular ones, the regular CO2 guns. I don't know if you can see that hammer right back there, if you can see it move forward or not. But what that hammer right there will do is it will hit this little metal button right here, and that'll release CO2 just real quick. Guys, there's another little metal piece in front of it right there, you can see it, that actually has a magnet on it, because they're magnetic BBs. Oh yeah, same with this and the magazine right here, it'll actually hold your BB in spot, and then this right here grabs it, it pushes it, and then it'll go through the barrel and just it'll shoot. But yeah, there ain't much to really review about this one. You can't field disassemble it or whatever it's called. You can't. Yeah. Yeah, that's the that's the Taurus PT-24/7 and the Sig 6R P226. Comment, rate, subscribe. Thank you.